Welcome to Cantaloupe Systems Seed LTE Verizon Cashless Overview video. In this video, we'll walk you through the LED behavior of the device from power on to cashless setup completion. We will also detail the behavior you will see when the device is sending and receiving data on the network. At the end of the video, I will provide you with contact information for Cantaloupe Systems customer care team. Okay, let's get started. Before you install the device in your vending machine, there are a number of important steps you need to take to prepare for the installation. First, make sure the firmware on your machine meets or exceeds the minimum version recommended by Cantaloupe. If you're not sure about that, you can contact customer care to get the information. Next, be sure your device has been activated and is ready to install. And if your machine will be cashless, be sure an administrator has activated cashless for the device using the Manage Add-ons page in SeedWeb. 3. Your vending machine needs to be in good working order with no errors reported by the display. 4. If this is a new install, look for the DEX and MDB connections on the control board, that is, the harnesses and plugs to accommodate the Seed device. And finally, find installation locations for the following components: the antenna, the Seed device, the door switch and bracket, and the card reader. Here's a schematic diagram showing the cable connections of the various components. However, before you disconnect or connect any cables, power down your machine. This is very important to avoid damaging any equipment. When you begin connecting cables, be sure the MDB cable from the Seed device is connected directly to the MDB harness of the VMC. Connect the other end of the cable to the bill validator and the validator to the coin mech. Also make sure the DEX cable connection at the Seed device is secure, and that the jack on the other end is fully seated in the DEX port. The DEX port can either be on the end of a harness coming off the board or hardwired directly into the VMC board. Now let's see what happens when the vending machine is powered on after all the cables have been connected properly. As the device receives power from the machine via the MDB cable, it will begin its self-test and initialization process. Once the device is initialized, you should see the status LED illuminate. The telemetry LED will immediately begin to flash, indicating the modem is attempting to contact the server through the cellular carrier network. Once the modem has authenticated with the carrier, you will see the network and signal LEDs go solid. The telemetry LED will go solid once full contact with the server is made. The Seed device has the ability to communicate the level of signal strength the modem is receiving from the carrier. There are three ranges of signal identified by the LED color. If the signal LED is green, the signal strength is 13 or higher. If the LED is amber, your strength ranges from 7 to 12. And if the LED is red, the signal range is 1 to 6. Note that if the signal LED is red or amber when the modem connects, inconsistencies in DEX data transmission and cashless performance are possible. At any time after power-up, the Seed device may request a DEX file from the machine, indicated by the DEX LED flashing. If the telemetry LED is already solid green, it will begin to flash with the DEX LED. Note that the telemetry LED may already be flashing at the time the DEX LED begins to flash. When the DEX LED goes solid green, the Seed device has received the file. When the telemetry LED goes solid, the server has received the data. To summarize, when the status, signal, network, telemetry, and DEX LEDs are illuminated solid, you know the Seed device is connected to the server and it is sending data. You can force the Seed device to DEX the machine if necessary by pressing and holding the black button for 3 seconds, letting go when you see the DEX LED begin to flash green. The telemetry LED will begin to flash with the DEX LED. The device behavior and transmission of data will then follow the same process as I've already described. When the vending machine is filled and/or money is collected, the driver will press the big red button once to transmit the changes to the server. When the button is pressed, the restock and DEX LEDs will begin to flash. When the DEX LED turns solid green, you'll know the Seed device has received the DEX file. The telemetry LED will then immediately begin to flash as the restock LED continues flashing. When the restock LED goes solid, the Seed device has sent the data. When the telemetry LED turns solid, we know that the server has received the data. Keep in mind that the restock LED will be out by default when the machine is powered on, and will stay solid until the next restock, as long as the machine power is on. If for any reason the machine is shut down, the restock LED will be out by default when the machine is powered back up again. Before you move forward with cashless setup, there are two steps that cannot be overlooked. One, make sure the card reader cable is securely connected to the Seed device. And two, cashless must be activated. Check with your administrator to make sure cashless has been added to the device in the Seed web application. Let's take a brief look at the LED behavior for cashless setup. As the Seed device begins to set up cashless, the two LEDs that tell you setup is working are cashless and MDB. The MDB LED illuminates when cashless is able to communicate with the machine via the MDB cable. The cashless LED is lit when the Seed device communicates successfully with the cashless server. The most prominent component of any cashless system, of course, is the card reader. Throughout the setup process, the reader display will function as a communication tool to let you know where cashless is in the process. So as you power up the machine, the card reader will begin to display its own internal welcome message. This tells you the bezel has power and it is ready to receive messages from cashless. As cashless setup begins, the Seed device will establish communication with the VMC. Communication is confirmed when the MDB LED on the Seed device illuminates. The startup messages will then begin to appear on the reader display. At this point, cashless is contacting the server to set up cashless connectivity. Cashless setup involves a series of steps the server takes to prepare the machine to begin accepting cashless transactions. Once configuration gets underway, the bezel will keep you informed as to the progress of the setup process. Sometime between setup 1 of 10 and 7 of 10, you will see the cashless LED begin to flash rapidly. This means cashless is requesting the encryption key from the server. The key is required to encrypt data being exchanged with the processor. When the LED goes solid, the Seed device has received the key. Setup is almost done. When you see the display message change to swipe card or tap to pay, the setup process is complete. To summarize, when you see all the LEDs except restock lit solid, the machine is ready to accept a cashless transaction. Thank you for watching Cantaloupe Systems Seed LTE Verizon Cashless Overview video. If at any time you run into an issue or have questions, feel free to contact our support staff at 415-525-8100, option 1, between the hours of 6 a.m. and 4:30 p.m. Pacific Time. Our email address is support@cantaloupesys.com. If you need to order parts or accessories, you can use our Shopify website online. Just go to cantaloupesystems.myshopify.com.